invite you. Thank you, Athena, for that beautiful reading. Okay, I'm going to give you the option, all right? I have a book named The Body of Bushido, and I have three main characters in it. And I have some new stuff as well. You can choose from the three main characters, and I'll read something from one of them, or you can ask me to read something new that I've written. Okay, so let me tell you the choices a bit right now, all right? So Lobo is the wolf, the street hustler, the passionate poet in the book. Toro is the bull, always charging forward, nonstop, stabbed, but gets up and keeps going. Santo is the holy man of the gang, okay? Being holy has its strengths, but it also has its consequences too, all right? Then I have some new stuff that I've written, I've been working on. I'm gonna have a sabbatical soon. So I'll be off for a year and I'm gonna complete this book, hopefully get into another book as well. And this one is an educational autobiography. And the section that I have from the new book right now is about 40 pages into it. And it describes my education in the juvenile justice system. So go ahead, what do you guys want to hear? Lobo, Toro, Santo, or Ben Boxia?
I want the juvenile justice.
Yeah. Juvenile justice, all right, let's hear. I got one for the juvenile justice. Anyone else?
New stuff,
Miguel.
Ben Baxiara.
Okay, and last, don't worry. Santo, all right, the whole man, all right? We got three and one. Anyone else want to break it?
There's one more right there.
You want Santo? I still got 3-1. Diamond Day, come on.
Santo. That's it, right?
Santo, you're the breaking bad right here.
Santo.
It's got to be Santo.
No.
The holy man of the Barrio, all right? So this novel is entitled Barrio Bushido, all right? And roughly translated, Barrio is a Spanish word for neighborhood or streets. Bushido is the code of the samurai. All right, so this book is about the code of the streets. The code of the streets, all right. The setting is the late 1980s, early 1990s, when crack hit full force on our streets. Okay, all right. So this homeboy, Santo, as I said earlier, he thinks of himself as, and maybe he is, the saint of the Cholos. He's always there for his homies. But that also has dire consequences to it in that he gets stressed out. He gets paranoid. He goes crazy. All right? So this is from El Santo. Let me write it on the board. Of course, I grew up here in the city, in the Mission District, but I didn't want to mention names or to deal with complications like that because, you know, things, you know, are the way they are. So, in the novel, it is the City of Intent. Anybody get that one? What's that? City of Intent. So if the city of San Francisco, San Francisco, what? Go ahead, put it. Okay, all right. So city of intent. Intent. City. Intensity. That's where we're at right now, right? So this is intensity, all right? I know nothing but repetition and nonsense, and can tell you nothing you do not already know. I cannot tell you of magical experiences beyond the grave, or of adventures in mythical utopia. I can tell you only of the jokes I have played, the blood I have shed, tears I have cried, and the many moons that have passed for me since I was brought into this existence. I cannot tell you of emotions you do not already know. I can only give you words, because there are still words left. Words endure. The power of memory haunts. When I have no words left, I will let you go. I shall set you free. I promise. Mine was not to question the complications of a trifle world dominated by trifling matters. Mine was duty, honor, the battle with the illusion of beauty. I accepted blows to my face, pain to my pride, because I had to be strong for family, strong for friends, powerful for the next generation. My rules, my laws, my private constitution meant sacrifice. Sacrifice was the epitome of success, and it is what put the smiles on everyone's faces. Don't get me wrong, I laughed, played jokes, but I was also the power to look for in bad times, because you could not trust your mama or your papa, or your old lady that was probably out on the streets. But you could call me up, and I would be there for you. I would come when you called, because I loved you. 3 o'clock in the morning, whatever crime or time, there was love. Homeboy love. And if you expected friendship, you knew there was no better friend to have. I would not argue with you. I would not give you advice. I would quench your thirst. I would do whatever needed to be done without hesitation, because I was the friend you always dreamed of. Homeboys shook my hand. They accepted the relationship, because without us, we were nothing. We with no money and no honey. We with brown faces and rude manners. We the miserable kings, because we had each other, and each other was all we needed. Homeboys took my love, and I expected the same in return. That was the cost of my friendship. What's fair is fair. If I could do it for homeboys, then they could do it for me. Is that not balance? Balance was ultimately lost. But I also knew that losing balance was the price of our love. And no more screams out on busy streets, no more cries into the rainy black nights, because I give homeboys my life so they can have something for later. Take me and give my people a place to smile, a place they could hold their heads up without being ashamed. This is what I sacrificed myself for. I lost balance. I lost love and grace. Yet, I must go on and on. What's that I hear? Is it you crawling out of the dirt or swimming from the bottom of the ocean coming to get me? Is it you that I must fear? Is it you that I must guard against? Must I spend my nights expecting ghosts? Then I accept your threats. Come and get me. I am the sinner. I am the evil. I accept the fate for everyone. I come outside now with nothing but dust in my hands. I am here. I am outside. I am a little boy. Mama, can I follow you? No. You must stay and take care of your brothers, Mimo. With Papa, Mama stumbled into the bedroom. I took care of my little brothers. We played Hot Wheels and Tonka trucks. Opening my parents' door later, I took care of them too. I put out her cigarettes that was almost igniting the rug. And I pulled a needle out of his arm as he nodded up and down and drooled all over himself. I cooked up top ramen soup, boiled hot dogs, and the family was full. And I am begging you, please take this cup away from me. Take this cup away, and I'll be a good kid and bless you every day of my life. Thank you.
Oh, you can hold that up.